Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I pray that y'all blessed today in Jesus' name. And that y'all marching on with Jesus. And that you're doing what the Lord has called you to do. My friends, now's the time for us to stand up and be a voice for the Lord Jesus Christ. Now is the time for us not to be at ease in Zion. We're moving into some dark times. There's a big change taking place within the United States and the whole entire world. And we can't be sleepy Christians. We can't allow the spirit of fear to muzzle our mouths. We have to be a voice for the Lord Jesus Christ. Be the witness that Christ has called you to be. This is the time for us to be building ourselves up. This is the time for us to be stepping out in faith. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. This is how we grow in boldness, my friends. You're not just going to be bold all of a sudden when persecution comes and the pressure comes to your life, and all of a sudden you're just going to get this spurt of courage and just boldness is going to rise within you. No, my friends, you have to stand for the Lord now. Now is the time to stand for the Lord Jesus Christ. Today is the day of salvation. Today is the day that we need to be speaking up for the Lord. We're moving into the last days, and we can't be complacent, my friends. And so many people, they allowing that spirit of fear to muzzle them down. And this is a dominant spirit that you have to overcome. Everybody has to overcome it. This is why Paul encouraged Timothy. He said, stir up the gift that was placed inside of you from the laying on of my hands. For God has not given you a spirit of fear, but a spirit of power, love, and of sound mind. So Paul was encouraging Timothy to stir up his gift because he was coming under the attack of fear. Paul said, stir up the gift. Lay hold of courage. Stir that thing up. Don't allow fear to muzzle your mouth. Don't allow fear to bring you into a place of complacency where your gifts get locked up, where your testimony gets locked up, where you become ashamed of Jesus again. So many people are like that right now. My friends, to this day, there's still imaginations and thoughts that come into my mind when God is telling me to do certain things. It's a spirit of fear. It assaults our mind to try to hinder us from stepping out and doing what Jesus is telling us to do. All kind of imaginations come into my mind. All the cops are going to come. They're going to come against you right here. Don't lift up your voice. And the Lord's saying, speak, Jacob. Speak. But the spirit of fear is trying to drop all these imaginations. So I have to lay hold of courage. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. I have to bring resistance against the spirit of fear. I have to recognize this spirit trying to hinder me from doing what the Lord is telling me to do. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. And I have to stir up the gift, just like Paul told Timothy. You have to lay hold of courage. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Courage is not the absence of fear. It's recognizing it's there and not allowing it to control you. Recognizing it's there and not allowing it to muzzle your mouth and stop you from doing what Jesus is telling you to do. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. So let's be a voice for the Lord Jesus Christ. The days are getting darker. We're moving into the last days, my friends. And if there was ever a time for us to be the body of Christ, that time is now. If there was ever a time for us to be a witness for Jesus, that time is now. If there was ever a time for us to blow the trumpets and sound the alarms, that time is now. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Let's be a voice for the Lord. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Let's lift up our voices. Let's cry aloud, spare not. Let's tell the people that judgment is coming. Let's let them know that there is a way of salvation, and that's Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's be a voice. Y'all be blessed today. In Jesus' mighty name, be encouraged. Don't be in complacency. Don't be just a hearer of the word and not a doer, because so many people are like that. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. They just hear the word. They just see other people doing the will of God, and they never engage in ministry. They never engage in what God is commanding them to do. And they just sit around and they are complacent. They had ease in Zion. They are hearers of the word and not doers. And the Bible says, be ye doers of the word, not hearers only, deceiving yourselves. So hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Let's be a voice. Let's be the body of Christ. Let's be the hands, the feet, and the voice of the Lord in this dark and dying generation. So glory be to the Lamb of God. Y'all be blessed. In Jesus' mighty name.